Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. The prices of essential commodities are very high and life for everyone is very hard. We live therefore under threats of strikes which if they come off and are bound to paralyze our development schemes to say nothing of the inconvenience caused to citizens and the financial loss which the country's exchequer can certainly not support in view of the steep rise in prices, the pay commission is bound to recommend some kind of relief. I personally am glad that a commission has been appointed because whatever restrictive and or penalty legislation is brought in and can never make for general containment and well-being, either mental or physical, and without these three can never be any enthusiasm in the hearts of the workers nor any industry on their part. Now, why has there been such a steep rise in food prices and why is the government unable to control the same? Production figures, we are told, have not gone down. We have had good harvests last year. Then where has the food gone? Is inflation responsible to a large extent for this debacle or are our figures for production wrong and how much of our food grains have undergone into the hands of black marketers? Why cannot government bring these anti-social elements to hell? These are questions which have to be faced squarely. Increase in salaries which will cost the exchequer hundreds of crores of rupees. Where is the money to come from in addition to what is needed for the plan? As far as salaries are concerned, the time has come, I think, for government to fix a minimum wage for the workers and to give him relief in the shape of free primary education for two of his children, old age pension, free living quarters, fair price shops rather than dearness allowances. I feel the moment anybody's salary is raised, he is inclined to spend more. A socialistic pattern of society means, as I understand it, a society where everyone has food, shelter, clothing and employment and equal opportunities for his material, moral and spiritual development. If the salaries of our workers are fixed at a reasonable minimum and the other relief given to them, I think we shall be fulfilling one of our main objectives, that is an improved standard of life for millions. I have often felt that perhaps we lay too much stress on our big projects. Full stop.